So I got a 3D printer. I mean, I know you know that, you've seen the title and the thumbnail of this video, but it was something I'd thought about for a really long time, but had held off from because I'm not sure I need more hobbies in my life. But, you know, I was browsing Thingiverse one day, which is a kind of online resource of free models to download and print yourself. And I just was searching for coffee stuff. And there was a lot. And I wanted to know what it was like. And I thought I would find out and share that experience with you for a video, because it's kind of interesting. You know, can you print your own coffee accessories? Should you print your own coffee accessories? Or get a friend to do it? So I printed 5 different things for this video. And I'll go through each one of them and talk about why I picked it, why I think it's interesting, and what the kind of implications of all of this stuff is as 3D printing becomes kind of a thing that is everywhere. Now, I bought a Prusa, if you care about these things. I bought a kit. I don't know if I would buy a kit again. It wasn't difficult to build, but it wasn't easy to build. I guess it was satisfying to build. You know, I understand what all the pieces do and how it all works, and that's kind of a good thing, I think, long term, if I want to upgrade pieces of the printer or that kind of stuff. But wow, did I underestimate how long it would take me. But I got it working, and I started printing, and I love it. I love it. It's just, it's incredibly satisfying, and it's everything I feared it would be. But let's talk about some prints, because I think there's some cool stuff here. Now, frustratingly, Thingiverse has a kind of tip function where you can tip the creators, and I wanted to do that, but most of them don't appear to have that function set up on there. I will be trying to track them down to compensate them in some way for having contributed to this video, because I think that's really only fair. But they've designed and shared some cool stuff, and it's free. You can just go there, take the model, and print it. And if you own a printer, the cost of printing is negligible. Oh yeah, one more important thing. I am like the person who just bought their first espresso machine and is finally getting like good espresso at home. I am very excited. I am excited about this hobby. I know nothing really beyond how to do what I'm doing right now, and I have nothing really to teach anyone yet. So don't take any... I'm not going to teach you anything meaningful about 3D printing today, because I don't know anything meaningful about 3D printing. Let's talk about the prints, because the first one just kind of blew my mind with the fact that it exists, or that it didn't exist outside of Thingiverse. It's this, made by a user called JUK. I think this is brilliant. This, do you know what this is for? Let me show you what this is for. This is a moka pot sort of basket stand. Because those are stupid things to dose. Let me just get one. Now, the problem with this part of the design and being weird about coffee is that weighing, say, your dose into this is not easy. You're trying to balance this on a set of scales. Come on, when you balance. There you go. Precarious, awful as an experience. But someone just made this, a little stand. It's just a little stand that you can just put your thing in, dose your coffee, and it won't fall down. I just think that's cool. I just think somebody saw a problem and created a fix that no one else was going to fix, right? Because only certain numbers of moka pot users care about this or would worry about this. But I just love that it's fixed. And for pennies, I have a solution to a problem that I genuinely have had. And someone made this and shared it for free. One of the things I do worry about as I make this video is that someone will watch this video and be like, oh, I make things, my business makes things. That's cool. I should make that. I should take this design that's available for free and commercialize it, or just tweak it slightly and do that. Don't do that. It's not cool. It's not okay. We'll find you and call you out and be mean about you on the internet, if that counts for anything. I just think this is a great little innovation, a great little solution to a problem, and that's kind of available to people who care enough to want to fix the problem. Anyway, JUK, the guy that kind of made this or shared this or uploaded this to Thingiverse, thank you very much. I appreciate this. This is definitely going to go into rotation and use in this kind of thing. And I should probably do an updated video on the moka pot soon. Now, that was genuinely the first thing that I printed. And the second thing that I printed is a little bit dull, but also just kind of cool. It's this. And I'm consistently impressed by how nice it feels. I mean, I've had 3D printed stuff in the past. I've had 3D printed parts on equipment or kind of 3D printed accessories bundled in with stuff. And I'd never really thought about what could I make at home. Now, as you've noticed, the set has slightly changed. We're moving spaces and kind of rebuilding the kind of kitchen set. And these, I'm going to print a couple of these, are going to go in there. It's a wall-mounted portafilter holder. 3 screws, mounts on the wall. Take your portafilter and just click it in. And it fits beautifully, really well. This is obviously designed for the kind of 58mm side-on lug, so something like a Simonelli portafilter or a Victoria Duino portafilter wouldn't fit in this the right way, but for the kind of standard side-on lugs, 58 mils, really nice fit. Credit to Jim Higson, the user who uploaded this in 2017, for making and sharing this. I think it is delightful. But speaking of espresso and portafilters, the next thing I printed was a little bit bigger again. Was this. It's a thing, it's a bit confusing. It's designed specifically for the Neewer grinder, which I just so happen to have here. Now with the Neewer, typically you would have a dosing cup like this. This is the new one, it's very nice, and it sits there, and you grind into that and give it a shake and put it in your portafilter, but maybe you don't want to do that. Maybe you want a different workflow. Maybe you want to grind straight into the portafilter. Now, I don't know how many Neewers are out there in the world, but it's a good amount, but as a percentage, the people who want to grind straight into a portafilter, not high, so no one's going to build a solution for you and commercialize it, I suspect. But you can 3D print one. If you take this off and this off, you'll see there's a little bolt here. Let's just take this bolt out. And then this goes on there. And now you're grinding. Oh, you're just grinding straight in. Straight in! Now again, the thing that's kind of interesting to me is you might want to change this slightly. You might want this slightly higher up, slightly lower down, it depends. You can do that if you want to. Now, this looks like it could get a bit messy. It might have benefited from having like a dosing ring around it. But of course, I made one. I printed a dosing ring because you can, that sits inside the portafilter, because you can, because it's easy. How delightful. What I liked about the model for this one, it actually came with choices of how you wanted to do your dosing rings. You could have one like this that sits inside the portafilter, the same user, the same files. There's variations of how you want to do it, and it's just there. So now, well, you can dose all neatly, and it fits beautifully, perfectly. Now, it is important to acknowledge, once something like ground coffee is touching the stuff, this is PLA, and PLA is not food safe. So, you know, if I was to make this for kind of regular usage, I might switch to something like PETG. But just for this video, for demonstration and for me learning what I'm doing, PLA, super easy to work with, had lots, and yeah, I made a dosing funnel that works really nicely. Now, the last thing I want to show you, I need a portafilter with a dosing funnel in to show you, and I think it's really cool. Probably the coolest one of all of them, if I'm honest, though it is a bit more work and it isn't just PLA, there's more stuff. But I think it's just cool. Now, if you're thinking, I want one of these, but I don't have a printer, well, hang around for a second, because this video has a sponsor, has an ad in it. It means I'm going to print a few of these different things and just give them away to you if you have no way of accessing a 3D printer, if you've got no friend with a 3D printer, if that's just impossible to you, we'll do a little giveaway. And that's possible because this video has an ad. Squarespace. From websites to marketing tools to online stores, Squarespace is an all-in-one platform that lets you build a beautiful presence online and run your business. What I love about Squarespace is that when you have an idea, it's really quick and it's really easy to make it a thing. Because you start with one of their templates, and they have a whole bunch of different ones depending on whether you're trying to build an online business or showcase your cafe or your portfolio, but you're not staring at the equivalent of a blank piece of paper. You have something to begin to fill with your words and your images and to create something that looks and feels how you imagine it in your mind and have it be online incredibly quickly. And once you hit publish, it's going to look good on every device, every browser, and there's nothing to patch or upgrade or install. It's just going to keep looking great day after day with nothing for you to worry about. But if you do have issues, there is 24/7 email customer support. And as I always say, don't take my word for it. I know you have an idea in the back of your mind. Just click the button down below and sign up for a free trial and build it. See how easy it is to build that website, to create that idea. And when you're ready to launch, use code JAMESHOFFMANN for 10% off any website or domain. Thank you to Squarespace for sponsoring this video. So this terrifying looking thing is a 9-prong WDT tool, a Weiss, or Weiss, I've seen Weiss, I don't know, distribution tool. And it's designed to break apart the clumps in your bed of coffee. And this one is great. It's really good. And just to show you what I mean, you would use it to sort of whisk around the grounds here, make them all fluffy, break up any clumps. Lovely. Beautiful results. Better extraction, more evenness. I haven't done a video on puck prep, and I'm going to discuss a load of different distribution tools like these kind of things. But broadly speaking, in many, many, many scenarios, I think they're really good. I think they're useful. I think they help you make better coffee. I think they're worth the time and effort. And I just love that there's a 3D printed one that is this good. Now, this is uploaded by a user called J Kim Makes, and it's It's kind of two pieces. There is a separate sort of holder for it that you can print, that you can kind of leave it in. But the two pieces are very simple. They just thread together. You've got a sort of top part of the handle, and then inside you have these. Now, ironically, you buy these to clean the nozzles on 3D printers. It's just a little pin for doing that, and it works well. But you can use them to make a distribution tool. I bought these from Amazon. I'll leave a link down below if you want to sort of get some of these needles for that sort of stuff. I'm not sure I'd recommend like just buying one and doing this. I think having 9 of them in one sort of thing is very cool. There are obviously kind of commercially available versions of these tools now, pretty widely available on a bunch of different websites from different manufacturers. This is a touch cheaper, probably 20 pence worth of filament here and £7 worth of needles, which you could probably get cheaper if you hunted them out a little bit more. I didn't do a lot of hunting. I just went with the ones I could get quickly and easily. But yeah, that's probably £7.50 by the time I factored in electricity and all the rest of it or whatever else. So it's cheap. But I will say, as a tool, this 3D printed open source tool is as good as anything anyone is making anywhere. And I think that's great. I do. Clearly, there's a big community around 3D printing. There's a big community around coffee. I think, obviously, crossover is super interesting there, too. But yeah, genuinely impressed. Like, it fits together really nicely. It looks really good. It works really well. And I made it. I mean, I didn't. I just pushed go on a printer. But I feel like I made it, and that counts for something these days. It was satisfying to create this thing. Now, I'm not going to say it's all easy and perfect all of the time. I've had failed prints, you know, along the way. My first attempt at this kind of went wrong, and the print failed about halfway through, which was maddening. I've had prints not stick to the beds quite early on. But to me, it has been an unexplored aspect of the kind of wider online communities, and I've just wanted to print some stuff, try some stuff, and show it to you, because I think it's cool. I think people are inventing really interesting solutions to problems and sharing them with everybody. And that is a good thing. And I'm also really interested to know if you have one or, you know, have access to one. What have you printed that's been useful? Drop a link down in the comments below. I want to know what has been useful to you. All right, I'm going to leave it there. Please, please share your favorite models, ideas, inventions down in the comments below. But for now, I'll say thank you so much for watching. And I hope you have a great day.